Hello, and thanks for joining us today. I have got Harrison with me today, and we are going to be talking about kind of tips and tricks from an RPA recruiter and maybe things to keep in mind, skills to look at honing. But before we dive into the questions that I have for you, Harrison, can you give everybody an introduction?
Absolutely. Thank you for having me, by the way. It's good to be here. So my name's Harrison Goode. I'm one of the co-founders of EdgeTech. EdgeTech is a emerging technology recruitment business. We operate globally, based in the UK. We work out into the United States, across Europe, and obviously the UK as well. Some of the technologies that we recruit into include robotic process automation, naturally. We also do quite a lot around intelligent automation, so things like conversational AI, NLP, process, task mining, and then some more advanced technologies as well around machine learning and AI. In terms of the types of positions that we recruit for, it ranges from junior developers and business analysts all the way through to C-suite and VP positions. So yeah, that's a little bit about us. Hope it paints a bit of a picture for everyone out there.
It does. Thank you for getting us started with that. So when we take a look at kind of the demand for these types of roles, you said, you've got this large swath of positions and technologies that you're recruiting for. Have you seen a uptick in the demand for roles in intelligent automation or any kind of changes or trends that you think are important to kind of note?
Yes, yeah, definitely. We've seen an uptick over a number of years. More recently, since COVID, there's been a huge uptick over the past sort of 6 to 12 months. But prior to that, the reason that we really set up EdgeTech almost 3 years ago now was that we spotted an opportunity in the space where RPA and other sort of intelligent automation technologies were really becoming quite spoken about. They were coming through to market. Vendors were receiving lots and lots of funding, which was creating a lot of hype and a lot of noise in the market. So we saw the opportunity to start EdgeTech to really focus on these sorts of technologies. So yeah, there's definitely been an uptick. Since COVID has sort of taken place, we've seen even more of an increase in demand from a lot of organizations. And I think due to the situation of work for a lot of organizations and businesses across the globe, it's forced them to take an inward look at their businesses and realize that they're probably not as digital as they first thought, and really thought about what they could do to make their business more efficient, perhaps run a little bit leaner. And naturally, the first thing that a lot of those organizations look at is automation, software automation, or maybe other intelligent automation technologies to help the business and also help their customers as well. So it's definitely been a busy couple of years for us at EdgeTech, and it seems that the market is just, it's still on an upward growth curve. So yeah, very exciting times.
Great. So I want to go into a little bit of those tips and tricks that I teased at the beginning there of skills that people that are looking to get into the roles that you're recruiting for in intelligent automation. What are skills that are critical from your perspective that companies are looking for that people should be focused on building?
So I think outside of the specific RPA tool experience, whether that's one of the leading vendors or perhaps a lesser known vendor, outside of the technical hands-on experience, I think skills around continuous improvement, skills around process improvement as well, always stands very well for any organization looking to hire people into these types of positions. So if you don't necessarily have any RPA experience, having some experience around process analysis or the process improvement side, understanding what a process looks like, whether that's within a bank or perhaps within a retail organization, the processes will be different. But having that core understanding of what that process looks like and if there are ways to improve that, that's naturally a good first step for anyone looking to move into the RPA or an intelligent automation space. It's, it's all focused around process. It's all focused around people. Aside from that, the people piece actually leads me on to just having good general communication skills, working with different team members, working with IT teams, working with business teams. If you've had those sorts of skills and experience before, or you're able to get that sort of experience and exposure, then that works really well as well. Because as we know, RPA, intelligent automation, can touch all areas of the business, and having someone who is adaptable, who knows how to deal with different people in different teams, that's really valuable. And naturally, I think the RPA tool experience is also great to have for people who are out of the industry, who are thinking about, you know, what does it take? All of the vendors out there, there are so many free resources that people can do for free training, whether it's into development or whether it's being a BA or you know, maybe into sales and learning more about it. There are so many resources out there online for a lot of the vendors that it can give you enough of a jumpstart and hopefully add another string to your bow if you are looking for a new job or speaking to a potential employer.
Great. And so I do want to kind of expand a little bit on that last comment that you made of, you know, taking advantage of some of those free resources from a BA perspective or a sales perspective. But for folks that are maybe not as technical in nature, and that's like me raising my hand, because I get this question a lot. How do you start to get into the industry if you're not a developer and you're not in, or and you don't have kind of those practical skills there? For some of those other positions, like those leadership positions, BAs, other things that aren't going to be doing strict development.
Yeah, so I think to get into the industry, I think as long as a lot of the skills are transferable and relatable, and a lot of them are a lot of the time. So if you're, for instance, a project manager managing different digital transformation projects, it could even be that you're an ERP project manager or a CRM project manager. The core concept of what that software project and program looks like is very similar from an RPA project to something else. The technologies differ and some of the processes might be a little bit different, but the core capability of that individual still remains the same. And then, like I said, if there are courses online that you can look at, or perhaps on some of the vendor websites to have a look at some training, some free training and resources to upskill yourself to bring your current knowledge up to speed with what an RPA or an intelligent automation project looks like, is something that you can do. And that's the same for, you know, perhaps a business analyst as well. If you've been just a business analyst working on other technology projects and you want to get into RPA, you want to try and upskill yourself, take a free course online, have a look around. There's plenty out there. Even just having a quick Google, you'll find some that are really useful, can back up your knowledge. And then if you go in for an interview for this job and you secure an interview, then you have some of that knowledge. And I think a lot of the time, most employers, that willingness to learn, putting yourself out there and really pushing yourself to further progress and develop in your career is something that a lot of employers like and really favor, to be honest. So, yeah.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for joining me today and talking through some of these ideas. Again, to stress what you said, there are so many resources, even like conversations like this, that yes, you can take advantage of on the internet that are going to help you upskill and learn a little bit more about the industry if you're looking to get involved. And the other thing that I would say is now you've got a resource. Reach out to Harrison if you've got questions, or start looking at the posts that they are sharing of positions that they're helping find the right fit for. So I want to encourage everybody, make your way over to Harrison's LinkedIn as well as EdTech's LinkedIn. And you guys have some groups and stuff like that that you're doing, that you're really active there. And so you guys are a wonderful resource for anyone looking to get into the industry. But thank you so much for joining me again today, and have a wonderful day, everyone.
If you're looking for expert tips on how to get started with your transformation or looking to hone in on your approach, make sure that you subscribe to our channel to catch our weekly Digital Transformation Talk series, where we interview experts from around the world on how to make it happen.